Elon Musk has long talked about providing fast-speed satellite internet to millions of people around the world. But it has always looked like something that will be achieved far into the future. But now it seems that the billionaire's dream may be on the verge of becoming a reality sooner than expected. Can Musk really deliver Starlink worldwide internet coverage this September? Well, we'll find out in just a second. But before that, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. Called Starlink, the project is designed to use thousands of relatively low-cost satellites to provide broadband internet globally, even to remote areas that currently do not have access to the internet. According to SpaceX, unbounded by traditional ground infrastructure, Starlink can deliver high-speed broadband internet to locations where access has been unreliable or completely unavailable. Elon Musk had announced that SpaceX had started working on communication satellite networks back in 2015, also stating that there is a significant unmet demand for low-cost global broadband capabilities. Around the same time, SpaceX established a new facility in Washington to work on the new communications, Starlink Communications. The initial goal was to send two prototype satellites into orbit by 2016 and construct the first satellite planetarium by 2020. However, the company struggled to create a low-cost receiver that the user could readily install. As a result, the program got delayed and the first prototype satellites did not launch until 2018. Following the successful launch of two prototypes, Tintin A and Tintin B, SpaceX was able to test and refine its satellite design. SpaceX kept a tight lid on what laid ahead for the Starlink project until November 2018, when the company gained clearance from the Federal Communications Commission to launch 7,500 satellites into orbit on top of the 4,400 already approved. By May of 2019, the first batch of production satellites had already been launched into orbit, and people all over the world had begun to see a train of rapidly moving satellites in the night sky. It is now 2021, and SpaceX has launched almost 1,800 satellites into low Earth orbit and has over 10,000 active customers. That sounds like a pretty big number, and it is. Starlink has long been the largest satellite constellation in the world. However, this doesn't mean that Starlink is ready to provide full-fledged satellite internet service. Starlink will need to have up to 42,000 satellites in its constellation, which means it is still a long road ahead for Starlink. But is it really? Because Gwynn Shotwell, the president and chief operating officer of SpaceX, seems to think otherwise. Shotwell said at a Macquarie Group conference, "We've successfully deployed 1,800 or so satellites, and once all those satellites reach their operational orbit, we will have continuous global coverage, so that should be like September timeframe." SpaceX, particularly its CEO Elon Musk, never fails to surprise us with their ambitious timelines. This time too, it seems like Musk is pushing full steam ahead with plans to provide full service a month earlier than Shotwell predicted. In a series of tweets published on June the 25th, Musk praised Starlink's recent milestone and also offered insight into its future. He indicated that all of Starlink's orbital planes will activate in August. However, it will take approximately another half year before Starlink broadband is accessible from the North Pole. Musk's tweet reads, "Starlink's simultaneously active users just exceeded the strategically important threshold of 69,420 last night. All 72 orbital planes activate in August, plus many other improvements enabling global coverage, except for polar regions, which will take another 6 months. Starlink currently operates its beta in 11 countries, including the US, the UK, Australia, New Zealand, and parts of Europe. Coverage will also be expanded beyond southern England to northern England and parts of Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland." According to Elon Musk, SpaceX's goal is to make the service available for the same price in all countries, with taxes and shipping being the only significant differences. When converted from local currency to USD, Starlink should be equally accessible to anybody with internet access. At the moment, pricing remains relatively high in established cities and medium-density populations in general. Users will pay $99 per month for typical download rates of 50 to 150 megabits per second and latency of 20 to 40 milliseconds, but will also be charged a significant cost, $500, for the user terminal. For the time being, that price will most likely keep it out of reach for the majority of internet users in both developed and developing nations. SDon Joyce, a Nokia director who works from home at a remote lake cottage in Canada, recently ditched his painfully slow phone line internet in favour of SpaceX's satellite broadband service, Starlink. Starlink, which cost him $600 Canadian, $486 US for hardware, and a hefty $150 Canadian monthly fee, delivers blindingly fast speeds when uploading videos or streaming movies. However, during calls on Microsoft Teams and Zoom, Joyce experienced dropouts. If you're in the city and you have alternatives, I wouldn't recommend it. But if you're in the country, like in the middle of nowhere, and you're getting pathetic internet service, then it's definitely a competitor, he says. Well, indeed, SpaceX and Starlink are almost solely targeting rural internet customers who have no access at all or service that is virtually unusable. Most homes in those conditions rely on extremely expensive and low-quality cellular, satellite, or DSL connections if they are connected at all. Thus, that captive market of many tens of millions of people around the world is ready for the taking. In many situations, Starlink will be the same price or even less expensive than current alternatives, while enhancing the user experience by one or more orders of magnitude. Now, this raises another question. How fast will Starlink's internet actually be? Having established a constellation of almost 1,800 satellites, Starlink is now offering an early beta version of its service in various parts of the world. Once the router and dish are set up, the dish links to SpaceX's satellite constellation, offering future download rates of up to 210 megabits per second. To put that in perspective, that is more than 6 times the average download speed in the United Kingdom and faster than 95% of US connections. However, SpaceX states that the service maxes out at 150 megabits per second during beta. SpaceX's official website writes, "Users can expect to see data speeds vary from 50 megabits per second to 150 megabits per second, and latency from 20 ms to 40 ms in most locations over the next several months as we enhance the Starlink system. There will also be brief periods of no connectivity at all. As we launch more satellites, install more ground stations, and improve our network and software, data speed, latency, and uptime will improve dramatically." SpaceX has successfully launched more than 20 Starlink satellites into orbit so far. The satellites are attached to the top of SpaceX's reusable Falcon 9 rocket and launched into orbit, with each launch typically releasing 60 satellites. And thanks to the reusable launch rockets, Starlink's low orbit satellites cost a fraction of the price of typical satellite launches, making it easier and more affordable to launch satellites at scale. However, as much as SpaceX has been praised for setting a new standard for reusability, it has also been under fire from the general public. The first potential issue highlighted is that there are now over 5,000 satellites in low Earth orbit. Increasing this number might increase the danger of collisions and debris falling to Earth. But when questioned about these issues, SpaceX responded that they believe they have the most advanced system for space debris mitigation, citing the Starlink satellites as an example, which are designed to be capable of fully autonomous collision avoidance, meaning zero humans in the loop. Although it is too early to say for sure, it is in the company's best interests to ensure that their system actually works when the unavoidable happens. However, we can surely say that demand for Starlink satellites is indeed soaring for the time being. In May, Musk announced on Twitter that his new Starlink satellite internet service has already had 500,000 pre-orders. He wrote, "Only limitation is high density of users in urban areas. Most likely, all of the initial 500,000 will receive service. More of a challenge when we get into the several million user range." As per estimates, if SpaceX obtains 25 million Starlink subscribers, it would make roughly $30 billion in revenue every year, 10 times its earnings as a launch provider, which sends satellites into space for governments and other companies. This is indeed great news for a company hoping to earn $3 billion per year from the project, to fund SpaceX's even more ambitious goals of establishing human colonies in space. "We think this is a key stepping stone on the way towards establishing a self-sustaining city on Mars and a base on the moon," Musk says. What are your thoughts on SpaceX's new project, Starlink? Do you think they'll be able to provide global coverage by September? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video on Starship's new floating launch pad that is shown in the end screen. I'll see you there.